Thanks, guys. I'm here with Flyleaf. What's going on?
Hey.
We're missing a few members, but that's cool.
Yeah.
You know, Jared, I was hoping to talk to Jared a little bit.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's all right.
He would have loved it.
Yeah. You guys actually had your first live TV performance here on the Fuse stage. What has changed since then?
We've been extremely busy. We actually went around the world, I think, since then. So that was amazing.
That's cool.
So yeah. About a year on the road.
So. Wow. Yeah. So you guys have been headlining a tour now, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. How's life on the road been so far?
It's been an amazing experience. It's cool getting to travel as much as we do, you know, and getting to experience all the different cities and, you know, different cultures and stuff.
Where's been your favorite place?
Australia.
Australia.
Oh, yeah, that was really cool. It's
definitely weird.
It's
swimming with the dolphins and stuff.
And seeing dolphins.
Yeah. I tried to, you know, try to back out.
He did jump off a bridge in his underwear, and I was so traumatized because of how tiny his underwear were, but...
It was great. There's in Adelaide, this pier going out over the water is like clear. You can see all the way to the bottom.
It was beautiful.
We all just ripped off our pants and jumped in.
It was fun.
we're headed to the airport because we're flying to the next city. In Australia, you fly to each city.
Right.
If it's quicker or something. And they put our luggage in a different vehicle. And so we stopped by the beach on the way to the airport because none of us had seen the beach yet. We didn't have our swimming trunks because they were their luggage. So we had to make do.
So pants off, dance off, right?
That's right.
Cool. And so those are great highlights, man. I wish I had those experiences. But your fans are obviously really inspired by your lyrics. You know, you guys talk about some really home-hitting stuff. You know, how does it feel to have a fan come up to you and be like, you know what, you helped me through this situation that, you know, that I was going through?
It really, really makes all the stuff that sometimes we feel bad having to give up, you know, like really close relationships with our families. We've been on the road for 3 years, you know. Like, today's my little sister's birthday. She's 15.
Oh, so happy birthday,
happy birthday, Stefana.
Happy birthday. Yeah.
And that's like, that's a hard thing to have to, like, you know, come home to and see my sisters grown up. But but then again, when I talk to her about it, she's like, well, you know, if you keep going, I know I can keep going, you know? And then those kids come, and it's like I have all these, you know, 15-year-old girls that say that, and it's like, okay, well, maybe it's worth it.
Yeah, that's what makes it worth it.
Yeah.
And it brings a smile. You bring a smile to somebody's face.
So, yeah.
That's beautiful. And you're heading back on the Family Values Tour, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you're going to be with bands like Evanescence. Who else we got here? Right. Korn, Atreyu, and Hell Yeah. I like to say Hell Yeah.
Okay.
What's it like being a part of a tour that big?
It's unreal.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Like I'm sure you know you've listened to these bands, you know, coming up, right? And now that you're playing with them on stage,
you know
what is that like?
It was real surreal. Last year we were with Korn and Deftones on Family Values.
Yeah.
And Deftones were my favorite band since I was 14.
See?
So getting to be on the same stage was like
it's so weird just even being on the Family Values tour. I remember, you know, being a freshman, sophomore in high school, and like, you know, sitting in our, like, English class or something, like listening to the records, you know, because they put out the CD every year, and you're like, wow, you know, like, I don't know what it's like to do that, you know?
Yeah, for real.
And it's so weird that we're doing it. It's really weird.
All right. Man, it's crazy. We're about to check out your video for Fully Alive. You know, were you surprised about how that track took off?
Well, I think it's, like... It's been pretty cool the way that it's continued to, radio continues to spin it, and I don't know. Are they going to play that video right now?
I think we are. We've got plenty more to talk, we'll do it right now. We got plenty more to talk to these folks about, but right now let's check out their latest video. Here's Flyleaf with Fully Alive. That was Flyleaf with Fully Alive, and lucky me, I'm hanging out with the band right now. Now, Lacey, you said that you wrote that song about one of your friends.
Oh, yeah, we were on the tour with, it was the first tour we ever did with Trust Company.
Uh-huh.
And Kevin, the singer, just got married to his wife, Layla, and obviously that's the first, that's the name in the song you hear. Mm-hmm. And she's just an amazing person, and like kind of, it kind of tells her story in the song a little bit, but now it represents lots of people and,
that's cool.
and lots of different stories.
Yeah, it's getting out there. And actually, you know, new thing is female lead singers with bands. I know we had Paramore here also, and they were really cool. You know, what do you have any advice for girls, you know, trying to lead bands now?
Well, I think that one of the things I think that's hard for girls is to really take people's advice, and at the same time, don't betray yourself and don't use being a girl as a gimmick and just be who you are and, you know, I don't know, just make sure it's not like you're using that as some kind of like, hey, you know, just rock out.
Just rock just out. Just do your thing. Do what you're supposed to
be
do.
Be honest. That's most important.
Right.
That's important.
All right. Well, don't worry, guys. Flyleaf is not going anywhere just yet. But right now, I'm going to hand things over back to Holly and Steven. Welcome back to The Sauce. That was a look at All Around Me, the brand new video from Flyleaf. Video's really cool. How was that made? Like, run me through that one.
It was crazy, man.
Yeah.
They built
you guys
this.
Look like you had fun, though.
It's every kid's
so
dream.
Cool.
Oh,
yeah.
I felt like I was 5 years old. It was cool.
That's exactly what you feel like.
Yeah, man. That's dope. And you've been trying out new material on tour. What has been, like, the most response you've been getting? Like, which track is giving, like, is everybody, like, yeah, rocking out to?
Probably a Cassie or Fully Alive.
Yeah.
Oh, the new ones, though, right? Justice and Mercy.
Yeah.
Justice and Mercy is getting huge response.
Yeah.
Well, we named our tour after that song, kind of. So.
Also, oh, it's kind of fitting, then, right?
Yeah.
That's dope.
And we wrote it for our military.
Really?
So, yeah.
That's cool. Gotta love the troops out there.
Yeah. My sister's a second lieutenant in the army. My cousin Rajiv, he's in the military also.
Yes, God bless them out there, right?
Right.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
And you guys are doing a show out here in New York City tonight, right? The Fillmore.
Right.
Fillmore, right? With Kill Hannah and the Sick Puppies.
And Resident Hero.
And Resident Hero
from Texas.
Yeah.
Nice. And yeah, you guys are from Texas.
Mm-hmm.
You're here in New York. What's it like playing in New York City? Like, this is a huge, huge thing in New York. Like, what's it like as it compared to, like, everybody else?
It's cool. It's always, I mean, New York and L.A. are, they're so, like, industry, you know?
Yes. Yeah.
Because they're like, yeah, it's got to be good because this person's going to be here and this person's going to be here. And
it's either really great or really scary.
Sometimes both at the same time.
Yeah.
And I was playing in Texas. I'm sure you get some home love, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's fun.
Yeah.
That's the best, most laid-back you know, loving kind of shows is at home.
So. Yeah, I'm sure. So you get all that love deep in the heart of Texas, right?
Deep in
That's
the right. heart.
Cool.
Good job.
Yeah, you see that? I know a little bit of something. But anyway, big thanks to Flyleaf for stopping by. The band will be out on road all summer, so be sure to check them out when they come to a city near you. Steve and Holly, you guys are going to get into some more music, right? I hope, right?
Absolutely, yes. Definitely. We got one that hasn't even been played on The Sauce yet, so first time for everything.
Yeah, definitely. It's 30 Seconds to Mars, who have also toured with Kill Hannah, who rule. Please tell them I said hi, Flyleaf, one of the best bands. You got to go see them. And-